Hello everyone. So in this session, I'll be discussing the important updates which has been released by IFOA for the September 21 examinations. So this handbook was released by IFOA 4 5 days back, and there are a few important changes which has happened from the previous examination. The very first few things are very basic. First of all, the minimum technical requirements, it's almost the same as last time. For Excel, for basically Microsoft Office, Excel, Word, you need to use the 2013 or above versions. You cannot use 2010 or 2007. Again, the time and the date is as per the as mentioned in your paper, is as per that of UK timings. So make sure if it's written 8 a.m., it means 8 a.m. UK time. So you have to change it, and you have to calculate it on the basis of the Indian time. We are 4.5 hours ahead of UK. So in that way, you have to calculate the time, and you have to give your exam as per the IST time, right? Then a few important things. The question paper which you'll get will be in the form of a zip file. So you have to unzip the folder and get the PDF. So you need to extract the zip folder. So you need a zip file extractor that should be there in your device. Again, to read the PDF documents, you will need a DOM reader. So make sure you have a DOM reader in your laptop so that you can read the PDFs. Then the exam formats, we know about this. CM1 and CM2 will happen in Word. Paper A. For paper B, it will be Excel. Excel files will be given to us. It will be in the form of zip folder. In the zip folder, we'll have the exam paper in the form of PDF, and the Excel files in the will be there. You need to extract these files first, and then you have to work on it. Make sure you extract these files and work on it. If you do not extract it, then your work will not be saved, right? And then you have to upload all of these Excel files. Suppose there are three questions, most probably you will get three separate Excel files. If that is the case, you have to upload at the end these three separate Excel files together, right? This is for CM1, CM2. For CS1, CS2, your paper B is again same. It will happen in Word. And second, paper B will again happen in Word. You have to submit your answer in Word. You have to copy paste the R codes to your MS Word, and you have to submit the paper in Word again. Now the important change which has happened is the exam length. It has been changed. Earlier, paper A was of 3 hours 15 minutes and paper B was of 1 hour 45 minutes. Now this timing has been changed to 3 hours 20 minutes for paper A, and paper B it is 1 hour 50 minutes. So they have actually increased 5 minutes for both paper A and paper B. Why they have done it? Because mainly to they have given the time for downloading the paper, right? So this, the moment your exam starts from that point to 3 hours 50 20 minutes, your uploading process, your downloading process, and giving the paper is everything included, right? So 3 hours 20 minutes, I download the paper and I write my paper in the MS Word. This time allotted, 3 hours 20 minutes, is for all of these things, right? For uploading the paper at the end of your exam in your exam portal, you will get another half an hour for that, which is 30 minutes extra for uploading the paper. Again, I'm repeating this. For 3 hours 20 minutes, you are given this time to download the exam paper from the portal, the IFOA portal. You have to write down your paper. This is your exam time, and the moment the 3 hours 20 minutes are over, you will stop writing, save your work, close your Word file, and upload the Word file in the exam portal again. Similarly, for paper B, it will be 1 hour 50 minutes. So basically, this extra 5 minutes, they have included it within the exam time only. They have actually increased the time for downloading the paper, but you can definitely, if your paper is downloaded within 2 to 3 minutes, you can start writing in your Word file, right? So the 5 minutes is basically for downloading, or if anyone is wanting to print the exam paper, you can print the exam paper within this additional 5 minutes which has been given and included within the exam length itself. Okay, then next we have 30 minutes. As I mentioned earlier, it was 15 minutes. Now you have extra 30 minutes to upload your answer script. So for example, my exam is starting at 1 o'clock, right? So I will have 3 hours, 20 minutes to write down my paper, which is 4:20 will be my exam ending 1 o'clock. So I will have 3 hours and 20 minutes. So basically it's 4:20. My exam will end. I have to stop doing my work. I have to save it and I have to then upload it within the portal. For uploading, the half an hour will start at 4:20 p.m. So at 4:20 p.m., the half an hour, the 30 minutes for uploading will begin. Now in this uploading time, you have to make sure that you do not do anything extra, because they will keep a time. They will see when the Word file was created. So two things they will see: when the Word file was created and when it was last modified. So if you modify the Word file in this 30 minutes of time, they will know that and your paper might get cancelled. So do not do this. Create your Word file during the time of examination, which is your 3 hours 20 minutes, and stop writing within this 3 hours 20 minutes. Do not do anything else. So what you have to do is, as soon as 3 hours 20 minutes is done, just save your work and close your Word file, and do not reopen the Word file, because if you reopen the Word file, your modification time will increase. That is not what you want to do. This has also been clearly mentioned by the IFOA in this handbook, that do not open the Word file. Suppose after 3 hours 20 minutes, I've completed my Word, I've saved it and I've closed my Word file. And for example, I want to check whether I've done it properly or not, and I reopen the file. Do not do this, because the moment you reopen the file, it will be captured in that modification time, last modified time, and it will extend the time limit and your paper might get cancelled. So do not do it. In those 3 hours 20 minutes, create the Word file, save it and just close it. Do not reopen it, even that during those 30 minutes which you have for uploading. What I will suggest is 3 hours 20 minutes, complete it, save your work, close the Word file and just upload your paper. It will just take maybe 5 minutes and you will be done for your exam. Do not wait till the very end of your 30 minutes to upload the paper, because anyway you cannot do anything in those 30 minutes. You cannot change, you cannot make any updations to your Word file, right? Also make sure, do not change the Word file to PDF and then upload it. You have to upload it in the doc format, which is in the Word format itself. For paper B, CM1, CM2, you have to upload it in the form of Excel only, right? It should be in the form of Excel spreadsheet. For paper B, it should be in the form of Word, MS Word only, in form of paper, in paper A. Do not change it into PDF or whatever it is. It will not be acceptable, right? Next thing, when the sitting subjects which require answers to be provided in Word, you may wish to use another software for the aid of calculation. This can be, so basically this I have covered in my mathematical typing videos. So when I'm saying this, this means that if you do any particular calculations in your Excel or in your R programming and you want to, you know, show that in your MS Word. Suppose for paper A, let us say for CM1, we are doing profit testing and I do it in Excel file. And Excel, and then I maybe copy paste it. Do not forget to show the workings. All of these are discussed in my mathematical typing videos, so I will not discuss it further over here, but make sure you see my mathematical typing videos for that. I will also pin it down in the description box, the entire playlist. Do not forget to show the calculations. If the calculations are not there, you will not receive the marks. And also it might so happen you will receive a plagiarism mail from the IFOA. So it's very, very important. You can use Excel, you can use any other software for your calculation, but make sure you give entire workings in your Word file for all your questions. Okay. You can only use the functions which are there in 2013 or previous, basically 2013 versions. You should not use any functions which are maybe in 2019 or 2020 versions. Anyways, whatever I've taught in class, it belongs to only 2013 version itself. There is no function which has been taught which belongs to this recent versions. There is one thing called dictation functionality, which is also there in MS Word. So many of you have texted me that can we use that? You cannot use that. It's there in Office 365, wherein you can use the dictation facility of MS Office, of MS Word. Do not do it. It is prohibited. You cannot do it in your exams, right? Many of you are asking, can we insert an Excel file within an Excel page within the Word? No, again, prohibited. You cannot do this as well. Okay, the next thing is mathematical formula and symbols. So you cannot write down and then put it in Word. All of these are very common things. You have to type everything in your MS Word, save it, and then you have to submit the paper. You cannot write it down in paper, copy paste it, or use any drawing tools. Like, you, if you have maybe MacBook or Apple Pencil, you cannot do that. Surface Pen, you cannot do that. You have to type it down, everything. You cannot use the dictate one. You cannot use the drawing pens. Okay. Next, these are a few notations which have been given in this particular handbook. These are more or less same as the previous ones. And these are what I have referred to in my previous class, in my mathematical video classes as well, typing videos as well. So you all can refer to it in my typing in Word, MS Word classes. Now, the next thing is to ensure that you protect the integrity of the exam, please give your exam by yourself. Do not get into any collusion, because they have these softwares wherein, you know, your paper will be examined, and if any similarity has been found between your paper and someone else's paper, then definitely it will be considered as to be a collusion, and you will be receiving a mail for plagiarism. So do not do that at all. Let's move to the next point, and it's about plagiarism. It's a little debatable, but what you need to consider over here is, first thing is that obviously you have read the co-reading, right? Which is the acted co-reading. You have gone through it, and now when you produce your answers, it might be on the similar terms to that of the co-reading which you have already done. What I will suggest is, what IFOA has in fact suggested over here is, if anywhere you refer to the textbook or any of the acted materials, please make a reference over there. So it should be clearly written within each paragraph. If a paragraph has been taken from the acted material, make sure you write in the very bolds or maybe in italics that you have referenced it from that particular material. I will also show you the format of how to reference it. It's mentioned in this particular handbook. Now, questions like definitions, principles, basic lists, all of these might be very, very much related to the acted material. In that cases, generally, candidates will not be investigated for plagiarism in these particular aspects, because it's very likely that your solution and someone else's will be a little bit in similar terms, right? But you can, if there is even 1% of possibility of collusion, you might receive a mail still. So do not enter into any collusion with anyone else. If you are referring to any internet sources or any other textbooks or any acted material, which is your CMP co-reading, anything, any such kind of things, make sure you give a proper referencing at the end of the paragraph. How to give the referencing, I'll show it to you at the very end. This is how you show the referencing. If you are referring to maybe CM1 co-reading, then this is how you will write it: IFOA CM1 co-reading. Mention the year. You always see that there's a year mentioned in the co-reading, maybe 2019, 2018, whatever, 2020, whatever the year you are referring to, the co-reading you are referring from. Unit is basically the chapter numbers. So unit 2, page 13, and the paragraph number also needs to be mentioned. And this is there in that particular page. You might see that there are sections in the CMP 3.4, 3.5. That is how they do it. So you just have to mention the entire thing. You have to mention the page number, the chapter number, the paragraph number, and the co-reading year from which, and the subject name from which you are taking the reference from. So it is very, very important that you do it. Also, even if you take the reference, you cannot take a complete reference. That is, you cannot completely copy paste everything from that particular source or maybe from internet source. You have to change it in your own words. You have to write it in your own words. You completely cannot copy paste from any other sources. I will suggest you, please do not take any help from any internet sources or any other textbooks. Just refer to the co-reading as your guide. Nothing else. And if you refer to co-reading, please mention the page number, chapter number, everything as it's been written over here. Okay. So again, there is one more thing which needs to be seen over here is that do not forget to download the paper. Obviously, if there is seen that paper has not been downloaded, It is definitely 100% a collusion. Do not do it. Do not exchange papers within yourselves, because it has been noted by IFOA this time very, very clearly that if candidate has not downloaded the paper and still uploaded the answer script, this means that there was some form of contact with other candidates, and it's a complete case of plagiarism, and you will be might be banned from giving other examinations in future, right? Also, these are the few points, and the examiners. So basically, examiners do not now, if there is referencing which can be done, this does not at all means that you will reference most of your papers, which means you are directly copy pasting large volumes of your answers from the learning material. Then this is completely considered as plagiarism, although this might not be possible because you'll have many application-based questions coming in your paper. Still, do not try to copy large volumes from your learning material, which is subject to minor amendments. You can make changes, small changes, do that. Do not directly copy-paste. Write it in your own words, and do not refer to the co-reading all the time. Maybe for one or two questions you are doing that, but even if once slightest chance if there is that you have referred to it, make sure you are writing the entire referencing very, very clearly. Same goes for table book. If you're referencing for any values, any formula from the table book, make sure you're also mentioning the table book name and the percentage and the page number as well. Please do that. Otherwise, it will be again considered as to be plagiarism, as to where is this particular number, where is this particular probability is coming from. So please do not do it. You have to refer to the table book anyway. Okay. Refer to the table book, refer to the co-reading, mention it over here. This is what is plagiarism all about. Now we'll come to how to prepare for the exam. So just 2 weeks before your exam, you will receive one mail from the IFOA. As you can see, the mails will start to, you'll start to receive these mails around 31st August to first week of September. And these are the three mail IDs which I have highlighted. Please take a screenshot of this and make sure you have this mail IDs with yourself, and keep this as your safe senders, because it might so happen that these mails coming from these email IDs are sent to your spam. So make sure this is not happening, otherwise you will miss out to a very important information. So click a screenshot of these three email IDs. These are very, very important. You will receive any update from these three mail IDs only, right? Now talking about what is the portal of examination, how it works. So basically it is a complete portal wherein you will need a two-step, two-factor verification is there. What is two-factor authentication? It's basically you enter your phone number first. Make sure your phone number is correct. If your phone number is not correct, you can log in to the IFOA login portal, the main page. You can log in into it. You can go to your own account and change your details. In your details, make sure your phone number is correct and it's working properly. So when you will receive all the links to the portal, everything from UK, from the IFOA. Just 2 weeks before your exam. Okay, I can also make a video for that. I will explain you how to do it. So there is a link to the portal, to the exam portal, online examination portal. Once you click on that link, it will take you to one page. It's given over here. I'll just show it to you. This is the mail which you will receive for your examination. And once you click on the setup my account, this particular portal will come up. You have to then create a password for yourself. You can create any password, put in any such password that you remember. You have to also remember this password during your examination, so keep it in that way, that manner. The moment you create that, it will ask you for your phone number. So make sure again this phone number you're putting in is correct. This phone number is something which is there in your IFOA login. So it should be same, it should match to that particular phone number. Put in your phone number, then you will receive an authentication code or basically the OTP which we call in your cell phone. This is how you will receive it, and this is the authentication or the activation code. Put this activation code over here in the portal, and this will verify your account and your verification. You have basically activated your account and your account will open up. This is how, this is a two-step verification. You give a password, you create a password, and you give your phone number, you will receive an authentication code in your cell phones. You have to put it on and you are ready for the examination portal. Now keep this one thing in mind that you have to do it every time. You have to basically put your number, phone number, every time you want to open this portal. So even during the exam, you have 3 hours, 20 minutes of time. Make sure you have already opened the exam portal beforehand. You are not doing it within this 3 hours, 20 minutes, because if you are doing that, you will again have to wait for getting the message, for getting the activation code, putting it. It will take again 5 to 10 minutes of your time. So make sure beforehand, maybe my exam is starting at 1 o'clock. I'm doing this at 12:30 or 12:45 latest and keeping my exam portal ready, from where my exam paper will be downloaded. So make sure you do this, because once you open the portal, it is logged in for maybe 5 to 6 hours. Do not log out of the exam portal. Again, why I'm saying this, because when you have to upload the paper, again what you'll have to do is again you have to log into the portal, again the same process of putting the phone number, getting the activation code, putting the activation code and getting it ready. So do not do it once you log in into the portal. Do not log out. Keep it ready for maybe next 4-5 hours. It will be there, and as soon as you finish your exam, you can upload it on the portal. You do not have to reopen the portal again, because each time you reopen, each time you have to get this authentication code in your cell phones. Now, the next very much important thing is to do an equipment check. What is this equipment check? Basically, when you open the portal, there is something called as so on the top, I'll just show you all the quick images over here. Suppose I'm appearing for more than one paper, all the papers will be listed over here. You have to click on this view exam button, which is here. The view exam button, the moment you click on this view exam button, this particular portal will come up, this particular page will come up, and it will ask you for this equipment check. What is this equipment check? This is two-step check. One is your download check and one is your upload check. You have to download, you have to check that whether you're downloading the PDF, the zip file is working or not, and uploading the Word and the Excel files are working or not. So click on this equipment check the moment, and there is no limit to equipment check. So basically, if I've carried out my equipment check in this particular laptop, but I want to appear, maybe something happens and I want to appear at my in my other laptop, you can again do the same equipment check in the other laptop or the other PC as well. So there are two checks which are there, download and upload. You click on this download check button. Or a PDF will be downloaded in this particular manner. Check PDF, it will be downloaded. You can open it and you can see whether it's working or not, whether the download check is working or not. Second is your upload check. For upload check, you have to basically browse through the documents you want to upload. Now, this is a very, 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 very crucial stage. Why I'm saying this? Because once you upload any wrong file, it cannot be undone. So to make sure you do not do it, IFOA has, you know, given one or two steps over here to make sure you do not upload any wrong file. So what you have to do is you have to click on this browse button, browse through the file you want to upload, which is your Word file or maybe your Excel file. Click on that, And here it will come with that. Here you will see that your that particular file name will appear over here. So suppose I am doing my SA4 paper, and this is how it will appear. Now there is a new feature which IFOA has this time introduced, is this preview thing. You can click on this preview button and you can actually preview the Word file which you have created, the Word file which you have made within the portal itself. So click on this preview and you will see your Word file, and then you are sure that this is the Word file I want to upload. If not, you can remove it from here, again select another file, click on this preview to check what is the file containing. Once you are sure about it, click on this upload, right? The moment you click on this upload, there will be one pop-up or a window which will come up, and this will say that this is the entire thing which you have created, file which you have attached. Suppose text document is what is I want to upload. This is how it will come, and it will click, and it will ask you to click on upload check. The moment you click on upload check, it will be uploaded. Here, this is how the preview of the paper will look like. This is how, the moment you click on this preview button over here, this is how it will look like. This is the preview of the paper or the Word file which I want to submit. Now, if you want to preview the Excel files, suppose I'm submitting an Excel file, I want to preview it. It can still be seen here. You can see the Word Excel file, but each tab, each sheet may appear in a different paper, different page. So that's fine. You can still preview your Excel file also here. Once you do it, you can click on the close preview button. You are sure about your submission and just click on upload button. It will be uploaded. Make sure you preview the paper before submitting, because once it's submitted, it's considered to be your answer script. You cannot change it later on, right? So it's very, very, very important that you do this equipment check, download, and the upload check. Both are very important. Suppose you face any kind of difficulty while your upload and download check, this is the phone number you can contact to IFOA. Please note this down. Also, keep this phone number ready, because if you face any kind of difficulty after your exam, when you upload the paper and you face any kind of difficulty, this is the number you have to call on. Right. Moving to the next thing is, so as I said this, if you want to change any personal details, please go on to the IFOA login and you can change the personal details from there, which is basically your phone number. Now, during the examination time, as I suggested, as I said, within the 3 hours, 20 minutes, you have to download the paper, complete the Word file, save it and close it. Once you close it, please do not open the Word file anyhow, because if you open it, it will be considered as the time of modification. So do not do it. Once you upload the paper, make sure you preview the paper first. You see whether everything is there or not, and then you just upload the file. Also, this is the exam portal. So you can just again take a screenshot of this, and you can keep this as the bookmark. So in your Google, in your Chrome, basically you have this bookmark option. Make sure you bookmark this particular website, because this is the website to the online examination portal. It's not started yet, so please do not start just logging into the portal right now. It will start after 31st August when you will receive a mail. You will receive a mail, and then you can only log into this portal. Anyway, you can still keep this in your bookmark list, because this is the portal you have to always log in for your examination and for your equipment check. Right? The next thing over here is, so this is, I've talked about, please make sure again, this is the assessment team number. Keep this number handy, so that if you face any difficulty during your exam, after your exam, while uploading the paper, please make sure you call on this number at once. Do not call me, because, or any one of us, or any of the teachers, because we cannot do anything at that point of time. It's only the IFOA, the team can do anything. Call them, tell them what is happening with you, and they might give you an authentication code. So this 30 minutes is for uploading. If you're not able to upload, then it's done. You cannot upload it later on. You cannot mail the paper to them. If you want to mail them, you need an authentication or the or a verification code that which you have received from the IFOA team, from the assessment team. And how will you receive that? Over this call. So suppose during my 30 minutes of time, I was not able to upload due to any of the reasons, I have to, within that 30 minutes of time itself, it should not cross that time limit, I have to call them this particular number, I have to explain them whatever is happening, they might give me a code and they will ask me to mail the file. This is the extreme scenario which can happen, but it might so happen that they will not give you any code if you do not upload, if you do not try to upload within that 30 minutes of period which is there. So as soon as 3 hours 20 minutes is over, save your work, upload. Do not do anything else within that particular point of time. So this is how your exam material will be downloaded. This is how, where you have to get the exam paper. What is this exam material? This exam material is generally given for paper B for R programming, that is CS1, CS2. If you need any data file, which is R data file, which IFOE generally gives 10 days or 5 days before, this is the place within the portal itself, when you just scroll down, this is the place where you will receive the exam material beforehand, and this is the place where you will receive the exam paper on that particular point of time during your examination, right? This is here, this is the place where you will download your paper and upload your file. If there are multiple files which you want to upload, suppose I want to upload multiple Excel files, maybe 3 Excel files together, you have to select these 3 Excel files together. So I click on the first Excel file, press Control, select the other file, press Control, select the third file, and at once click on the preview button, because you cannot do it one by one. If there are 3 files that you want to upload, you have to select all the 3 files at once. You cannot just upload one file, then upload second file. Once you click on this upload answer button, it's done. If you have uploaded one file, that is it. That will be only considered to be your only answer. So make sure there is an option of multiple selection. If there is there, you have to press Control and select all the files at once, right? And then click on upload at once. That is how it's mentioned. Now, how to rename my file? The file should be renamed as this way. You can again take a screenshot of this. Firstly, your ARN number, which is your generally 6 to 7 digits of ARN number. Then the paper name. If it is CS1A, then CS1A. If it is CS1B, then CS1B. Then the term, which is September 2020. It should be September 2021 for us. And then we have the paper, which is paper 1 or paper 2. Which is, anyway, if it's CS1A, then it's paper 1 as it is. So make sure this is the entire structure. You rename your file. Also, you have to mention your ARN in the header or the footer. So you can mention within the Word file, mention your ARN as the header or the footer. And this is how you rename your Word file during the time of examination again. Okay. So the timestamp, as I said, that the time you created your Word document and the time you actually last modified your paper, your Word file, will be noted. If there is any slight change in it, you will surely receive a mail from the IFOE. So save and close the document before the end of exam, which is your 3 hours 20 minutes. Do not reopen the file anyhow, because once you open it, it will amend the last modified timestamp. Even if you haven't done anything wrong, you have just opened it, still it will be considered that you have modified after that 3 hours 20 minutes. So do not do that at all. Right? Okay, so this is how you preview it. I've talked about it. Now, keeping all of these things in mind, I might also make one video on how to do the equipment check. But anyway, I've already explained you. Make sure to do it. After submitting your files, after you upload the Word file, this is a receipt which you will get on your portal itself. It will state, so let me just zoom into it. It will state the exam, what is the name of the exam, the date of the examination, your ARN, the upload time which you started to upload, upload finished, when the uploading finished, and the name of the file which you have uploaded. So this is a receipt. stating that you when, at what particular point of time, and what file have you uploaded, right? Also, this particular thing over here, this particular thing over here is the mail which you will receive in your mail ID, in your mail ID which you have given to the IFOA. Again, the same thing, the paper name, the ARN, and the upload time, start and the finish time, and the document which you have uploaded. These two things are there for emergency situations. Keep this handy till you get your results. Okay, so these for emergency and any emergency situations, I've already given you that number. Keep that number handy. Save it in your cell phones as maybe IFOA assessment team or whatever, so that you can contact them if there is anything going wrong with you. So 3 hours, 20 minutes for your exam time. Next 30 minutes for uploading time. For paper B, it is 1 hour 50 minutes for exam time, which includes upload and giving the paper, and next 30 minutes again for uploading. In those 30 minutes, you do not have to do anything extra. Okay, I have talked about more or less everything. I have talked about plagiarism. If you have any questions, you can ask us in the chats below. Okay, thank you so much.